River County authorities have identified three people who died in an explosion in a hunting structure earlier this month. They say 45-year-old Michael Bauer, 50-year-old Perry Federoff, and 46-year-old Misty Marple all died in the blast. They're all from Texas. That happened October 13th on private property in the Johntown community. Deputies believe the explosion was an accident caused by an unknown gas, but they still don't know what sparked it.
Guys, welcome back to another episode of Atlas Survival Shelters. I hope you're all having a fantastic day. Now, a lot of you guys have commented below, did you ever figure out who built the bunker that blew up that killed the three people? A news article came out on January 23rd that one of you followers actually forwarded it to me that was put out by KLTV, which I believe is in Texarkana or in Tyler. But I'm going to read you guys the article, and we'll talk a little bit more about it because I know who built the shelter. When you're done watching this video, you might figure it out yourselves. But this is what the article says. It says, Red River County, the State Fire Marshal's Office has released its investigation report regarding the explosion that killed three people in an underground doomsday bunker near Talco. The report by Sergeant Paul Steelman released to KLTV on Wednesday shows he was unable to determine a cause of origin of the October explosion that happened on Private Road 5042 in Red River County. The explosion was reported on October 13, 2019, after a family member went to check on a loved one they couldn't reach, but officials believe the explosion happened the night before it was reported. The victims, Michael Bauer, Perry Federoff, and Misty Marple, suffered burns and numerous lacerations, blunt force trauma, and possible fractures as a result of the explosion, according to the report. Bauer's wife told Steelman the purpose of the shelter was to be prepared for doomsday and that the property was going to be a place to live off-grid, according to the report. In the report, Steelman described the bunker as being 40 feet by 8 feet, single-entrance steel structure buried 10 to 12 feet below the surface. Investigators were able to identify a bathroom, kitchen area, and bunk beds. A notebook found inside contained writing indicating some kind of problem with the government, the report shows. It sounds like they're just trying to slander him there. An air quality test showed the presence of propane gas inside the bunker, according to the report. The propane was being fed into the bunker from an above-ground propane tank. A representative from Cooper Propane and an investigator from the Texas Railroad Commission examined the propane tank and line and found evidence of a substantial leak. But the report shows they were unable to determine that if that leak was the cause of the explosion or caused the explosion. The report shows a solar panel provided electricity to the bunker. No formal air conditioning or heating unit was found. Several agencies were involved in the response and investigation, including the Red River County Sheriff's Office, the Red River Office of Emergency Management, and Bogota Volunteer Fire Department, the Longview Fire Department, and the Texas Railroad Commission. I know who made the bunker. It's pretty obvious, but without saying any names, but I only know one company that puts propane water heaters in their bunkers.
So again, we're in this Ryzen S bunker, so they have to give up living space to store everything, so I can barely squeeze through the bunker right here. There's water leaking everywhere, it's rusting. Here's the other toilet. Again, there's an XL. This is a propane hot water heater. Which is, I will not put propane in a shelter.
I only know one company that's using Babcock Davis brand hatches on their bunkers.
Came about, but this is a this is the best looking hatch I've seen on a Ryzen S bunker. But it's a roofing hatch. Okay, it says a thin steel roofing hatch, but it looks better than the other ones that they had. But This is from Babcock Davis, too.
And I only know one company that's using rectangle tubing on the roof of their bunkers and square tubing going down the sidewalls. So I 100% recognize the construction, and I know very well who made this bunker. The sad thing about this is the people who made the bunker haven't expressed one iota of condolences towards the people who died. I haven't heard of them making one single change to change the way they are making the bunkers. And I haven't even heard them offer one ounce of sympathy towards the families of the people who died in this bunker. It's just sad. You know, you guys, you buy a bunker to protect you from potentially a bomb, not for your bunker to become the bomb. But the shoddy construction of this bunker, I want y'all to look at this picture here. I want you to notice that when this thing exploded, it blew the concrete off the roof of the shelter. Now, when I put concrete on the shelter, I put a mesh in there. My competitor does not. They just dump a slurry on there or some kind of concrete on there and they let it dry. So when this bunker blew up, it literally sent the concrete. Actually, I'm going to read some more of this article here. Because it talks about, where did it go? Well, I read in another article where basically they found concrete in the trees and the escape hatch 50 feet away from the bunker. So when this thing exploded, it literally blew all the dirt off the surface because the shelter was only buried about this deep in the ground, okay? It had, you know, it had maybe up to 12 inches of concrete. I don't know. No one ever measures it when this company puts it in, but they claim they're putting 12 inches of concrete on it. But it literally blew it up, blew off the concrete. I mean, it's just completely exposed. Blew the seam open on the corner, so blew the weld out. And, you know, it's just sad, but you know, this company is going to truck on making shelters, I guess, the same way they've done in the past. And if you ask them what happened, I don't know what they'll say. I'm sure they'll have a good story for it, you know. But I'll leave it up to you guys to figure out who did it. But so anyway, guys, I thought you would like to just know the current news on this bunker that blew up. So like I said, I'm going to put a link below, so you can actually click onto this article and read more about it. But it talks about all kinds of stuff in there. But you know what, guys? You know, if it walks like a duck, it talks like a duck, and quacks like a duck, it's usually a duck. And if it smells like propane, you find propane, and the only thing explosive in there is propane. I don't understand how these detectives, and they call themselves detectives, can call this undetermined when the only thing that's explosive in there and it smells like a propane tank in there is propane. So I find it ridiculous. I don't know who these officials are trying to protect, but you know, there are some family members that are going to want some justice about this. But guys, a word of caution, if you have a bunker and it has a propane water heater in it, please do me a favor, do everybody a favor, and do yourself a favor, get it pulled out. Put in an electric water heater, a tankless water heater, or just go without hot water at all, okay? You know, surviving in a shelter for 2 to 3 days is not going to really need everybody to take a shower. During peacetime, if you're using your shelter during peacetime and you like to use your bunker for recreation, it is nice to have a hot shower in there. But during wartime, I don't remember too many movies about Vietnam and World War II where they were so worried about hot water showers. So several of my bunkers don't even have showers, much less hot water showers. My bigger bunkers do, okay, because people are paying a couple $100,000 to have a bunker that feels like a house, and they want a hot water shower, so we do it. But on these smaller bunkers, guys, you're just going to probably wear your clothes for a few days. But realistically, when a nuclear bomb goes off and the fallout lands on the ground, that radiation decays within 24 to 48 hours. You see, Hollywood has done a great job of scaring the crap out of all you people that makes it sound like that's the end of the world. When the fact is that the radiation, the fallout decays so fast that basically it's almost harmless within 7 days or as long as 28 to 30 days. But realistically, it depends on how far downwind and the amount of fallout that falls on you. But a lot of these bombs blow up And the fallout goes so high in the stratosphere, but it drifts for days up there. So by the time that it falls to the ground, it's already decayed and it's basically harmless. It just looks like white snow all over your car. So I have a series of videos that are going to come out this week, okay, talking about nuclear bombs and the after effects. I hope you enjoy it. There's going to be a part one, a part two, and a part three about nuclear bombs, the size of the bombs, the largest bombs in history. And this is some old film, some old footage, and I think you guys are going to enjoy it. So guys, if you're not a subscriber in my channel, and I always hope that you are, make sure you like and subscribe to my channel. Share this video if you want other people to know about this bunker that blew up. Hit that little indicator bell, lets you know when more of my videos come in. But guys, as always, I love you. I'll see you on the next video.